Pod Machine, it's Maureen. Glad to see you're back, and if it's your first time here, welcome! For my first plug special video, I wanted to talk about the Peace Lily! The Peace Lily is on every top beginner plant list that you'll find online, but very few beginners know how to properly take care of it. No wonder why a lot of you on the comments asked us to do a plant special about it. Are you one of those people? Let me tell you the story of the Peace Lily.
Peace lilies are tropical, evergreen plants that thrive on the forest floor.
Oh wait, before we start, a warning to parents and pet owners. All parts of the peace lily contain a substance called calcium oxalate. This, if ingested in large amounts, can cause stomach and respiratory irritation. So keep it away from children and pets in case they decide to eat a few leaves. And if you're the worrying kind, just don't buy it. Anyway, back to it.
Peace lilies are tropical, evergreen plants that thrive on the forest floor. In this environment, they receive patchy sunlight and consistent moisture throughout the year.
It's quite useful to know which way your windows are facing in your home. This way, you can make sure to place your plants in a spot that they'll like. If you don't know, you can download a free compass app on your phone. Once it's open, stand in front of your window and look at the top of the compass. This should tell you if you're facing north, south, east, or west. So each plant will have its preference, but a peace lily will grow best in partial shade, so an east-facing window is best. I don't actually have an east-facing window in my flat at all, so if you're in the same situation as me, don't worry too much. You can also put them in rooms that have south-facing windows, which is what I'm doing right now. Make sure to put it well away from the window though, or your plant might literally get a sunburn. Don't put it in a place that is too shady either. So for example, a north-facing window sometimes might not get enough light. If that happens, your plant might not bloom at all ever, which would be sad. So replicating these conditions at home will make sure that your peace lily is happy and healthy. Peace lilies do not like the cold, so they can only be grown outdoors in warm, humid environments. So if you're in the UK like me, make sure to keep your plants indoors, away from drafts, as well as any cold windows, for example, over winter. Peace lilies do not like too much heat either though. They like the same temperature that most humans do, really. So around 21 degrees Celsius. So in the summer, if your peace lily is in a room that gets much hotter compared to the rest of your house, make sure to move it away from there, because it will show you that it's not happy. Seriously, you'll notice. So replicating these conditions at home will make sure that your peace lily is happy and healthy. Refreshing your plant's soil by repotting it every spring will help it get ready for the growing season. You'll want to first loosen the soil around your plant, trying not to hit the roots. Once you've gone around the plant, hold the plant at the base, making sure it's completely loose before you lift it up outside of the pot. Ideally, you would wait until the roots have filled the original pot before you repot. I obviously haven't done that this time, but it's okay, as long as you don't repot too often. Start getting the soil off of the roots, and you can just go for it. The plant will be fine, as long as you don't shred the roots to bits. Once you're done, check whether you can propagate it, because by this time, your plant might be getting too big for your liking. In an earlier video, I explained two ways of propagating plants, and this is the third one. Division, D The idea is to remove enough soil around the plants to be able to see the crowns of your peace lily. So the crowns are the base of the plant, the thickest bit between the roots and the stem. As you can see here, the peace lily grows in clumps. And can you see how it almost looks like it could be individual plants, each clump, each crown? That's the point. You can create a new peace lily pup by either gently separating one of the crowns from the rest of the plant with your hands, or use a sharp knife to cut it off. Make sure to use a crown, well, to choose a crown that has at least two healthy leaves with a bunch of roots attached. I always choose one that's already a bit loose on the side of the main plant and seems easy to remove. So just pry it apart, making sure to keep roots. And so that's the point of untying the roots from each other. So then you can be sure that you have some healthy roots that will be attached. Et voila! You've got a healthy new peace lily pup to keep or to give away. You can repot the peace lily pup and the parent plants and just leave them there. They're gonna be just fine. Peace lilies like moisture, but they really don't like being wet, too wet, over an extended period of time. It's best to let the first few centimeters of the soil to dry out before you give them a good watering. Check whether your peace lily needs water weekly. Don't give it really cold water though, because that might shock the plant. That tip is actually relevant for all plants, really. As I mentioned earlier, peace lilies are tropical plants, so they're used to a lot of humidity. If you have a humidifier, great! Just use it on your peace lily once a week for a few hours. If not, you can create your own mister. It's really easy to do. It works the same. And I made a video about making your own, so check that out. Peace lilies are sensitive to chemicals, including the chemicals that are typically found in tap water, such as chlorine and fluoride. Hard water, like the one we have in London's tap water, is also not good for this plant. So if you can, to avoid harming your plants, use purified water or filtered water, or you can boil water the night before and let it cool and use that, or even collect rainwater and use that to water your plant. My peace lily hasn't flowered in a while, and I suspect it's because I have been giving it tap water, which it doesn't like. So I'll try filtered water and report back on how that went and if I got any flowers. Another tip that you can use for all of your plants is to clean their leaves with a damp cloth. In the wild, plants would get rained on, but obviously that doesn't happen to your indoor plants. So a layer of dust can accumulate on the leaves, blocking sunlight, which reduces your plant's ability to photosynthesize. Photosynthesis is how the plant feeds itself, so you don't want that. Also, cleaning them now and then will keep the leaves shiny and nice. Before I leave you to try my top tips on your own peace lily, I wanted to share a super cool fact that I found while I was doing my plant machine research. Check this out. Peace lilies can apparently be grown only in water. So the roots are the only thing that are in the water, of course, and then the rest of the plant is suspended in the air in a way. So I find this really cool and it looks amazing, so I will be trying this at home really soon, hopefully. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please share it with your friends and let me know what you enjoyed about the video. Like and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you next week. Thank you.